Hello, Fourth Year. How are you today? I hope you are happy and fine. Well, today is Thursday, the 27th of August. And remember, you have to hand in, composition number 10 from the list and the email. Now we're going to check pages 80, 81, 82, and 83, the exercises I asked. And then you are going to go to revision on unit 10. I'm going to explain the revision. And then as homework, you have page 110, reading number 6, okay? Good. Well, shall we go to page 80? Yes, if it is okay, put a tick. If it is wrong, put a cross. Well done. All right, so exercises 6, 7, and 8, okay? From page 80, yes, 6, 7, and 8. Minutes. All right. Page 80. All right. There we go. So we have exercise 6, 7, and 8. Are you ready? 1B, 2A, 3E. Exercise 7. Invite, steal, lead, borrow, carry, react, travel, have. Exercise 8. 1H, 2D, 3E, 4A, 5A, F, 6C, 7G, 8B. Okay, is it clear? So let's go to page 81. Page 81. We have exercises 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Right, he has been stung by a wasp. Yes, she has cut herself or her finger. He has fallen or he's fallen off his skateboard. He's got food poisoning. He's fallen off the wall and she's tripped up. Yes, exercise 2. 1B, E, F, 2, C, E, F, 3, C, F, 4, A, C, D, E, 5, A, C, E, F, 6, A, C, D, E, F, exercise 3. 1D, 2F, 3B, 4G, 5C, 6E, 7, 8. Exercise 4. You can't use this beginning with all the endings except ignore. The verb is in the infinitive. If I were you, you should, I would, wouldn't, you'd better, why don't you? For example, get it looked at, go to A and E, keep an eye on it, put some antihistamine cream on it. You can use this beginning with all these, the ending except ignore. The verb is in the ing form. It might be worth, it's probably best. Have you tried? For example, getting it x-rayed, going to see the doctor, putting antihistamine cream on it, washing it. I wouldn't go logically with ignore. Yes, I wouldn't ignore it. Okay, good. Page 82. Yes, okay. 82. 1A. Incorrect options. 1, however. 2, all the same. 3, actually. 4, by the way. Incidentally. 5, before I forget. Exercise 1B. He's asking Jack if he should take part in an ultra marathon. He asked Jack because Jack knows him better than anyone. 1C, of course. 2, by the way, incidentally, to be honest. 3, anyway, in fact, naturally, obviously, of course, well. 4, anyway, even so, of course. Yes, okay. Exercise 2. I don't know what I would do in your position. 3, 2, even so, if you have the right training, you can do it. 3, as I understand it, you will do a race. You will do the race next year if you decide to do it. 4, that will give you plenty of time to prepare and see if it is a good idea. 5, I'm sure you won't regret it. Yes. By the way, we'll probably call in and visit you next month if we go to Scotland. Yes, okay. Well, and then you have a model answer. I'm sorry, it has taken me a while to reply your email. I've been thinking about you, said, of course. To be honest, I have never been faced with this kind of situation, so I don't know what I would do in your position. You are the only person who knows what your body is capable of. Obviously, doing a race like that is going to be a massive challenge. Even so, if you have the right training, you can do it. As I understand it, you will do a race next year if you decide to do it. That will give you plenty of time to prepare, blah, blah, blah. Well, it's up to you in the end. I'm sure you won't regret it. By the way, we'll probably call you and visit, blah, blah, blah. If you haven't made up your mind, we can talk about the ultra marathon a bit more then. Regards, Jack. Yes, that was an example. Okay, and we're going to go, and that was all, yes, because the next pages are for unit 11. Yes, okay. Well, so let's go to the explanation of the revision, and then you will be free. Okay, good, good, good. Wait a minute. We are all right. So that's the grammar part. Yes, okay. So you have to complete the sentences using will, using who, which, where, whose, and when. If you can also use that, write it in brackets. That is exercise one. In exercise two, you have to write the sentences using who, which, where, whose, and when. If you can also use that, write it in brackets. Is it clear? And you have an example there. Yes, is it clear? Remember, who for people, that for things, whose for possession. That's the woman whose husband is my doctor. This is the woman who I trust in. Yes, okay. This is the house where I lived when I was a child. Choose, circle the correct option. Then you have to complete the second conditional sentences with the correct form of the verb. So you have conditional two, if plus pass, yes, plus would, infinitive. Is it clear? Yes, acordate que el if no se separa del pasado. Puede estar adelante o atrás. Por ejemplo, she would call us if she arrived early. Yes? Or if she arrived early, she would call us. Okay? Entonces, esa es la pista. Que el if siempre va pegado al pasado en este caso. Yes? Esté adelante o atrás. Yes? Rewrite the sentences using the past simple and would plus infinitive. For example, if I didn't go to bed late, I wouldn't always be exhausted. Yes, okay? And that was all. Then you have the writing paper, and it says, read the extract from an email you received and write an email in reply. Offer Jake advice and give details about the problem you want to help with. Okay? So you have to read this extract that was taken from an email, yes? And you have to use the smart words, yes? 120 words only, the email, yes? Paramedic, appointment, trip out, crutches, food poisoning, the thing is, by the way, these are words that are in the vocabulary in unit 10, is it clear? Well, I wait for your revisions. Have a nice weekend and see you next week. Bye bye. Have a nice day.